Save the troubles.
It went up my fucking nose.
I am fucking hopeless. Good thing I'm not a bartender.
Oh god, I literally just cleaned this dishcloth. Sorry about all that mess. I'm actually a seasoned drinker. I'm just a freaking klutz. That's why that happened. Anyway, hello. What's up, you guys? Me, Luke. It is currently 8:15 on the 25th of January, 2020. It is a Saturday. I'm currently drinking some apple cider. It's pretty basic, but I've got a liter of vodka back there, so don't fret. We will be getting drunk tonight. But it is a Saturday night, and tonight I'm going clubbing. Or I'm going to a bar, and then I'm going clubbing. It's a bar and a club. Whatever. I'm going clubbing for the first time by myself. I've been clubbing now for, what, I just turned 20. I've been clubbing since I turned 18. I've been clubbing now for 2 years. So I'm very comfortable clubbing. I've done it pretty regularly. I've just never done it alone. So I wanted to document this experience because if you guys watch my video on my New Year's resolutions and my New Year's goals and everything, then you'll know that it was a goal of mine to do more things alone this year, get outside my comfort zone, and really do things that push me to work through my anxiety, me being an introvert, just push myself out there, and I want to grow as a person. So a big goal of mine is to start doing things that you would not traditionally do alone and start doing them alone. So far, I've not really done much of that this year. I went to a cafe by myself twice. That was really bad for my social anxiety. And today I'm going, well, tonight I'm going to a club and a bar by myself, which is a massive leap. I would have thought that I would have done baby steps, like maybe go to the movies by myself or whatever, but I've been in a really big clubbing mood. I went out last weekend for my 20th birthday with my good friend Holly, and we had an amazing time. Normally I go in like a group, but this time going with only one other person, what I realized is that you get approached so much more when you're not in a group. So anytime Holly went to the bathroom or anytime Holly was just kind of dancing by herself, so many people were approaching me and I ended up hooking up, not like making out and, you know, bit of grinding and whatever with 4 different people, which that's not the intention. That's not the reason I go clubbing, but it's definitely a perk that I don't mind occurring. Now, we did go to a gay bar. If you don't know, I'm bisexual. And I've gone to plenty of straight bars and I've made out with a couple girls, but with girls, I always have to put in a bit more effort, obviously, because usually I'm like, you know, going up to them or hitting on them. Whereas in the gay bar, in the gay club, a lot of guys would come up to me and it was just easier. It was fun. It was easy. I had an amazing night and I just felt so alive dancing with all these strangers, meeting new people. And I really wanted to do it again. However, in terms of friends, a lot of my friends work on the weekends. A lot of them have partners that they're busy with. And I just couldn't be fucked asking a bunch of them because more often than not, there's always a fucking excuse. And yeah, I'm trying to meet new people and make new friends because I've lost some friends. I'm over some friends. I have some great ones. Don't get me wrong, but I want to make some more. Oh, another thing. I'm so sick and tired of fucking dating apps. Oh my god, I'm so fucking over it. I have no luck with them. It's a waste of time. I would rather meet people in person, so that's what I'm gonna do. Past couple days have been really rough for me. Last night was Friday. Everybody was busy. I was home alone on Friday. I just watched a bunch of fucking TikToks and movies, and I just felt really shitty. And then today, I didn't do anything as well. I felt really shitty. And I was like, you know what? I'm gonna stop throwing myself a fucking pity party. If I want to go out clubbing or I want to go out and do something, why do I have to wait until I have somebody to do it with? Why can't I do it by myself? And the truth is, I can fucking do it by myself. And that's what I'm gonna fucking do, okay? Sorry, I've been like psyching myself up to do this for hours and hours and hours. I just got back by the gym, by the way, which is why I look like trash. I just thought that going to the gym would give me, I don't know, like a bit of, what's the chemical you get from the gym? Like dopamine, I think. It would, you know, maybe inflame whatever muscles I have just a tad. Make me feel a little bit more confident. Just get me pumped, you know what I mean? Get me out of the house. So I had a good gym sesh. It was Saturday night, so like literally no one was there. And I went ahead and bought some alcohol. I bought a liter of vodka, some mixer. I got some apple cider, literally just because it was like on special and I was like, why not? And yeah, I've been doing a lot of research today, which I know sounds so fucking nerdy, but that's just the type of person I am. Been watching a lot of YouTube videos on how to go out by yourself, how to meet people, how to approach people, how to go clubbing by yourself, been reading some articles, really just been doing a lot of research and really been putting things in place that force me to do it because I can talk myself out of things super easily. I overthink things so much instead of just doing them. You know, that's a lot of the social anxiety and all that. So, for example, I put in my contacts, which I only ever really do if I go out clubbing or I go out on day trips and stuff like that. So, I put in my contacts, and my contacts are not cheap. So, I was like, well, if I put in my contacts, maybe I'll be more likely to go out because I'm like, oh, I don't want to waste my contacts. I mean, if that wasn't enough, I was like, okay, well, I'll buy alcohol. You know, if I'm going to buy alcohol, of course, I'm going to drink it. And what am I going to do? I'm not going to just be drunk at home, you know? Like, no offense if you do that. That's just not really my thing. And another thing that I did, which I kind of wish... It's not that I wish that I didn't do this, but like, I'm gonna be honest with you, I'm very scared. Like, I'm scared to go out by myself. I'm nervous. I'm not scared of like getting hurt or anything. I'm just nervous of being alone and like the awkwardness of it. I've never done it before. So what I did is I have a friend who works in the city, and I know she works every day on the weekend, and she finishes work at like 11. So I was like, hey, do you want to meet up in the valley later, which is like Fortitude Valley, which if you don't know, in Brisbane where I live, Fortitude Valley is like the clubbing hub. There are all the clubs just in one suburb. She was like, yeah, I'll come after work, we can meet up. So yes, I am meeting up with someone at the end of the night, but I'm still technically going alone, and I'm going to be alone for an hour or two. So I think it still counts. And I thought this was another good thing. If, you know, having the contacts in and if having the alcohol didn't push me to go out enough, I thought that having plans to meet someone later on in the night would force me to go as well, because I just knew that I would find a reason to back out, and now I'm not going to. So that being said, that's kind of my thought process behind everything. I feel like I'm just talking so much, but I'm just really nervous. Also, I look like shit right now, but I'm going to shower, going to put a bit of concealer on my pimples and my under eye bags, going to wear a cute fit. I'm going to look good, okay? I think let's take a shot of vodka just for a bit of morale. Normally I go for Smirnoff, but Smirnoff is like a bit more expensive, and I'm currently saving for a trip somewhere. So I just got some vodka O. I'm going to do a shot of this. I don't have a shot glass, so I'm just going to drink out of the bottle. I'm sorry if this makes you cringe, but like, whatever. Mm. Ooh. Okay, cool. That was way too much. Look at that. Anywho, so I've got one cider down, one shot of vodka down. I'm gonna go have a shower and get dressed, and I'll get back to you when I have my fit. See ya. Focus on me. Alrighty, guys. I just finished showering. I'm currently naked. Don't know why I felt the need to tell you that, but that's the perk of living alone. I can walk around naked whenever I fucking want. I'm feeling tipsy already. That's the thing, is I haven't been drinking as much in the past few months, so I feel like I get drunker quicker. So I obviously don't want to like be too drunk when I get in there, because you got to have your wits about you. If you're going out there with the strangers, that was the worst British accent ever. So I thought I would just give you that update. I'm gonna take a little pause. You know, I think this big gulp of vodka, and I haven't eaten since lunch. I'm not going to eat, not because I want to get drunk quicker, but because, fun fact, I have IBS. So if you don't know what that is, it's called irritable bowel syndrome. And basically I have a very sensitive digestive system, which acts up in unexpected ways, and I get really bloated and uncomfortable. And I don't want to be like that at the club, because last time I was there, a lot of people, well, the people I was dancing with were like sticking their hands up my shirt and down my pants and whatnot, and like I just felt very self-conscious because I was bloated because I had pizza. So I'm just not gonna eat anything, and besides I'm not even hungry, but because of that I'm not gonna drink as intensely, if that makes sense. But anyway, I thought I'd give you that update. Also, I wet my hair, which is really stupid. I wasn't supposed to do that because I don't have a hair dryer and I don't want to go out with wet hair, so I'm just gonna have to wait for it to air dry before I can leave. And now I gotta choose my outfit. So let's go ahead and do that. Alrighty, so I actually have a lot of options, as you can see. These are like all of my button-ups over here. I kind of want to wear, I just bought this shirt and I haven't worn it yet. As you can see, it literally still has the tag on. It's like this rose button-up, but it's a long sleeve, and I feel like it's kind of a bit too formal, so maybe not. I'm thinking maybe like a, I don't know, I don't want to wear a polo. I want to wear a button-up. I want to wear something that like sort of stands out. I wore this shirt last week. It's like this pink floral shirt, and I mean, I made out with four people in this, so that seemed to do well. But then I also have like all of these blue shirts that I really like. I don't know, y'all, so many options for a little time. Kind of tired. I'll get back to you when I figure out what I'm gonna wear. See you in a bit.
You've been waiting for 10:30, no later than.
I am so
it. Alrighty guys, I have just ordered my Uber. It's about 10 o'clock. Let me just go ahead and show you my outfit. Sorry, I'm in a rush because they're like 2 minutes away. I was not expecting them to be here that soon. I am wearing this shirt from Connor. These black jeans that show off my ass. I don't know where they're from. My watch from, it's an heirloom. Where's my ring? Fuck. This ring that I got from a market. This Hermes belt and my Doc Martens. Okay, full fit, full fit. Alrighty, I think before I go, I'm gonna take one more shot just to make sure that I'm like, you know, decently tipsy so I can be kind of confident. So we've got our vodka. And our chaser. So we're pretty much good to go. And my Calvin Klein. Yep. Alrighty guys, let's go. I'm so nervous. I'll see you later. I'll try to see if I can film in the club. If not, I will speak to you tomorrow. Bye.
Bye, have a great time.
You guys, I'm in the city by myself and I'm really nervous. So at this point, I'd been at the club alone for around 45 minutes and I was just really overwhelmed. So I just went to the bathroom to have a little bit of a break by myself. And then I met up with my friend, so all was well. Alrighty guys, it is 4 a.m. I'm absolutely exhausted. We will pick this up later on once I've slept. Good night, or should I say good morning?
The next day.
It's like 11:30. I'm running late. I have a family lunch at 12 to celebrate mine and my little sister's birthday with the family. And I'm so fucking hungover. I think it was the vodka Red Bulls. I need to stop drinking Red Bull when I go out. But I am literally so hungover. You gotta do what you gotta do. You know what I'm saying? But I definitely had fun last night. I'll talk to you more about it later. Because honestly, I'm really dead right now, as you can tell.
Mom, the cake's gonna get ruined at this point.
Is that money?
No!
Oh, you put money in a case.
I was like, wait.
Oh my god.
I'm gonna have the money all the way.
Alrighty guys, what's up? I'm back. As you can see in my bedroom, my skin is really just not looking great because I've really just not been taking care of it the past couple of days. But anyway, that's besides the point. So I'm back from my lunch with my family. It was such a nice time. It was kind of difficult because I was like hungover and like my little brothers are really loud and we were in a restaurant, but like I made my way through. I got through it and some good carbonara. And yeah, it was actually kind of a combined family birthday lunch because I turned 20 the other day and then my little sister's turning 17 in a couple days. So that was nice. My mom actually baked a cake and like hid money in the cake. It was actually really funny. So yeah, I had a great time. I've been back now for about an hour scrolling through TikTok, making TikTok, thinking of TikToks to make. I fucking regret downloading this app so much. But anyway, that is not the point. I wanted to give you kind of a mini rundown slash story time of what happened last night because I didn't really tell you. And I want to tell you my experience. So technically, I did go clubbing and to a bar alone, just not for the whole night. I was probably alone for around 45 minutes, which is like not that much, 45 minutes to an hour, but like still for somebody who really struggles with like social anxiety and stuff, that is a lot. And I'm so proud of myself for doing that. I did end up meeting up with a friend, which I'm so glad I did because we had such an amazing night, such a great time. Liz, if you're watching this, I love you. Stayed out so late till 3 because that's how I know if I'm with people that I enjoy their company of. Because whenever I'm with people who I just don't vibe with, I normally want to leave the clubs at like 1 or 12 and go home. But when I'm with people who I genuinely love spending time with, I want to stay out like 3. That's what happened this time with my friend Liz, and that's what happened last weekend with my friend Holly. I'm just, in the new year, I'm just not hanging out with people who don't make me feel good about myself anymore. Like, if you're a negative and your energy and your vibes or whatever the fuck, just don't work with me and don't elevate my life and my mood. I ain't got time for you, bitch. And I just feel so much more mature thinking that way. Anywho, so let me give you a story time. So last I spoke to you, I booked my Uber and I went in the Uber car. It was actually really funny. So whenever I go in Ubers, I normally go with people and I like always never sit in the front of the Uber just because I hate it. I think it's awkward. I always prefer to sit in the back, specifically behind the driver, because I don't remember where I heard it, but I heard it somewhere that if you're in a car accident, the safest place is the spot behind the driver, because the driver is most likely natural reflex is going to protect themselves. And if you're behind them, yada yada, whatever. So I sat back there, but then I was like, okay, this is fucking awkward. So I literally asked the Uber driver to pull over so I could get in the front. I was like, oh, it's kind of hot back here. I want to be closer to the aircon. Could you just pull over? Then I sat in the front. But I'm really glad that he did that, that I did that, because he was actually pretty nice. And it like forced me to talk to a stranger and make conversation. And we chatted the whole way there. You know, it was a 25 minute drive and it was fun. And then when I got out the Uber, I was so nervous. I'm walking down the street by myself in the city with a bunch of drunk people everywhere. This guy actually stopped me. Like, he literally stopped me. And he was like, hey, just so you know, there's like police up there like raiding people. They're like really homophobic. I just thought I'd let you know because you're really cute. And I was like, okay, thanks. It was really freaking weird. He was like touching me and I was like, don't touch me. But then I went to go wait in the line for the club. I had a lot of like the anxiety voices in my head. You guys probably know what I mean, where they're like, oh my god, everybody's staring at you. Oh my god, you're so lame. Oh my god, you're alone. Oh my god, but when really nobody gives a fuck. So I just had to like breathe and like overcome those thoughts. And then once I got in the club/bar that I went to, is pretty big. It's got like 3 floors and like 5 dance floors and like all these different bars. So it was really good that I had options. So I kind of walked around the place a little bit, kind of sussed out the areas. I was not expecting it to be as busy as it was. I think because it was like the night before Australia Day, maybe it was more busy, but I got there at like 10:20 and it was packed. So I think if I want to do this again, which I am thinking of doing like completely alone, I will probably have to go before 10 just so I can go when it's more chill and I can actually meet people, as opposed to going late when everybody's like already established, the people they're hanging out with. But anyway, so I went to one bar and I just super loud in there and I was like, oh, there's no way someone's gonna come over and talk to me. So I went to another bar and actually got a drink and sat at the bar and like was just sitting there drinking, which nobody was really looking at me, I guess, but this one guy sat next to me and I just was not interested, like off the bat. Like, I was not attracted to him and he just seemed kind of creepy, but I wanted to be polite, so he was like making conversation with me or whatever. He was really weird, so he like put his hand down in front of me and I was like, the fuck? So I didn't know what he wanted, so I like put my drink in his hand because it was finished anyway. And then he was like, and I realized, I was like, does this guy want me to hold his hand? And I literally said to him, I was like, I'm not holding your hand. And he did it again and I was like, oh no. So I just like said I had to go to the bathroom, went to the bathroom, and then skirt left to go to another dance floor, and he fucking followed me. So I like found these two girls who were just sitting and I was like, oh, let me go sit down next to them. They were okay. One of them was talking to me and she like kept fucking spitting on me the whole time she was talking to me, so that was not great. I mean, the same creepy guy comes and sits next to me and this girl's like, do you know him? And I'm like, no. Hoping he would get the message, but he still didn't. So at this point I was like, fuck this, and I was like, I'm gonna go to the bathroom, as if I have like a freaking bladder problem. And I went downstairs to another bathroom. So yeah, I was really nervous, kind of just vibing, trying to get my confidence back, you know, trying to just really, you know, debrief, you know. And then I went outside and I bumped into somebody that I knew, so that was cool. I knew someone from one of my acting classes, so we chatted for a bit, and then he introduced me to his friend, so I danced with them for a little bit. And then at this point my friend Liz arrived, so I went and met up with her and then just went on the rest of our night and had fun.
I did manage to make out with one person, but they were a really bad kisser, so it was just not a pleasant experience. I don't know, tonight not many people were like vibing with me, which is okay, I guess. Like, I still had fun with my friend. Not every weekend's gonna be like the last, but the host side of me was a little disappointed.
But yeah, that was kind of the experience of me clubbing alone. Even though it was only a short period of time, like an hour, I think I was alone. I think I did pretty well. Like, I, you know, forced myself to talk to people. I bumped into people. Like, I really prided myself for doing that. And to some people, they may think that that's not even that big of a deal. But for me, somebody who struggles really bad with social anxiety, I really struggle to do things alone. Like, I'm a very independent person, but I struggle to do things alone that you traditionally do with other people, because I worry that other people are just gonna like think of me weirdly or judge me. After this experience, I definitely want to do it again, because I'm super proud of myself, and it makes you realize that it's all in your head. Like, you shouldn't overthink shit. You should just do it. Don't give yourself time to overthink it. So yeah, I'm gonna do more stuff alone. I want to go to the beach by myself. I want to go to the movies by myself. I want to go to a restaurant by myself. I want to do all these different things, and I would love to take you guys along for the journey by vlogging and stuff. So I might do this again. Let me know if you want me to, and if you enjoyed this video, give it a thumbs up, comment down below what you thought of it, and let me know if you want more videos like this. And as always, if you've not already, make sure that you subscribe and turn on the post notifications bell. so that you never miss another upload. All my social media is linked down below if you want to follow me, as well as my merch. And yeah, that's it for me in this video, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope to see you in my next one. I hope that you have a great day or night, wherever you are in the world. Bye!